Critters, go explore. We're home.
We devote. Harpocrates, dear Lord of Silence, we give you this graciousness for this meal you've bestowed upon us in the form of quiet reflection and devotion. We do this for you and for our fallen daughter, sister, family. 1 year ago today, you ushered our sweet Magdalene into the great beyond to stand by the anointed ones. We're not here to question your mysterious will, but to honor it, reflect, and cherish the memories of our beautiful Magda. We give you these silent musings. So be it said.
So be it said.
Perseus, I give you Perseus.
Go.
Aboard, Miss Red, all aboard.
Halt.
Magda, my beauty. Every year we will come to this place and walk the stone maze you love so dearly. An eternal promise that serves forever. And we'll set a small piece of you up into the yonder, to Arcadia. And though we let you go, you will live on in our shared experience. Go on, critters. Speak to how you loved her. Perseus?
She was always nice to me. She never pushed me around.
Sprout?
So, what's a pop kiss?
Really?
Yeah. No, I don't know.
Just take your hand.
I know.
Come on, okay. Take your hand. And then you just... kiss it. Come on.
Okay.
Do it. Go. Just do it. Yay! See, it's easy. Sloth time.
100%
yeah.
Sloth time.
So this is what's going on. Oh, well. Was it good? So you go kiss her?
It was magical.
Sprout, what did you love about your sister, right?
She always taught me new and exciting stuff.
Hold it gently. Gently. There you go.
It's not bad.
Isn't it beautiful?
It is indeed. Oh, like your grandfather left it to me. This is all going to be yours, this sanctuary. All the land and all the treasures that go with it.
Treasures?
Oh, yeah. Lots of them.
Does that include the, creepy horse?
What, Mr. Ed? You used to love that thing.
I hate that thing. It's terrifying. It looks right into your soul. It's judging us.
What?
Right now.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, it is.
Mr. Ed, stop looking into her soul.
Is Max coming over to play?
I believe Mrs. Woodhouse is bringing her son over, yeah. Percy has always been raised around you girls. He hasn't had an older boy to rough house with.
Percy's a dingle schlocker.
With all the fast words and the English language, you choose to make up your own. That's beyond you, Sprout.
Are you gonna stop calling me Sprout?
That's what you are, right? My little bean, my little seed.
But Mama always called me my real name.
Your mother always liked that name more than I. Did I ever tell you the story of when you were born? You were so tiny. You know, it was a miracle that you could fit right in the palm of my hand. And I knew that you're gonna be able to just push up like a little sprout through the dirt. I looked at you and you had me.
And I had you. I know.
She knows. Okay. Let's get some rest. It's been a long day. I think we've earned it.
Aww.
What? Sprout, you're still bothered by that sleep stupor? That can't bother you here. Not here at Sanctuary. This is safety. I mean, I know. I believe there's something special on your nightstand that will watch over you while you sleep.
You got me a present.
No, not I. No, I can't take credit. I believe it was Artemis, the goddess of hunt. Believe she left you something. You're welcome.
One, two, three, go. One, two, three, accelerate. Come on. Step. Doesn't the sun feel good? And I think I smell bird turd. I'm kidding! Gods, open up! Go get it, you dumb biscuit. Percy can run a mile, but it takes Percy a while. So close.
Report to? Like the head ranger?
There's really no head ranger.
Oh. The obvious free fall, you know? You don't want to read? You want some more coffee?
No, I'm good, thank you. Hey, what is your tattoo of?
That's Harpocrates.
Time?
Papa! I saw.
Excuse me.
Papa! You'll believe what I saw. I saw. All right.
May I have a word?
There's a Gorgon outside!
A what? Gorgon?
A Gorgon, Papa. She was tall, with a long, pointed face. She was evil, and she was like Medusa with no snake hair, and she was really
Sprout,
tall.
Sprout. There are no more Gorgons, Sprout.
I saw it.
I know, sweetie, but there are. The Gorgons are gone. Medusa was the last of her kind. And who killed Medusa?
This is one of her history lessons, Papa. Don't you believe me?
Yes. I believe that you believe you saw a Gorgon. Quite possibly, it was just something magical twirling around in that beautiful mind of a little girl.
I'm 13. I'm growing up.
That's the same sermon that I got from your sister. Lest we forget what happened to Magda. Now I would like you to go march back in there and give a proper apology to Mrs. Woodhouse for your outburst and this presentation, which, by the way, if you wouldn't mind. And then I think it would do you well to spend an hour in silence with devotion and look on at Artemis.
Apologize for the midriff, Ranger Woodhouse. For the mitra? Roy, you're too hard on her. Sit down. I only see you, what, once, like once a year? Every time I see you, you get prettier and prettier. I love your little headband. It's very cute. And your braid, did you braid yourself?
Magda taught me.
Magda? You know, Max lost his dad. You should... You talk to him. You guys would probably understand each other. Woodhouse?
You're listening to Youth and Revolt Radio with your boy, Slim Watts. Let's start a revolution.
Hey, Slim Watts. This is Ranger Stella Woodhouse, and this is a private park channel, so go take your revolution somewhere else.
You better tell him, Stella. Over and out.
Not funny. The dispatcher's kid steals his walkie sometimes. Here, check it out.
Are there a lot of Lady Rangers?
Lady Rangers? Really? It's like a bad 90s sitcom. Yes, there are a lot of Lady Rangers. Give me that. You know, just because you're a girl doesn't mean that you can't be a protector of the wilderness. Besides, girls are smarter. Why don't you go find Max? He was asking about you.
Okay.
Sprout, you've got really beautiful hair. You should let it out sometime.
Daft? Seeing gorgons and all?
What? Daft? Gods, no, Sprout. Come on. I look at you and I see what I always see. A fun-loving girl experiencing a wonderful childhood.
You think so?
I know so. Yeah. Now, are you two grown up to climb the home tree?
Magda's?
Yeah.
No.
Prove it. Ah! Ow! Whoa! Ah! You're still my little bean.
Stop.
Come on. I tell you what. You see that gorgon, you let me know. I'll brain it with my 7-iron.
Remember, don't look in the eyes, or she'll turn you into stone.
Oh, she'll have a difficult time staring me down when I knock her eyeballs out with my 7-iron.
Pa?
Sprout.
Are the gods real?
Come here. Of course the gods are real.
That's what gives... creation reason.
There's a God for every actual thing that happens. That's why I homeschool you critters, so that you won't be out there exposed to the otherness. They'll have you believe there's one true God for everything, Yahweh. That's not true.
Otherness? You said otherness. What does that mean?
The otherness. It's out there. It's a place full of chaos. And they'll try to infect you with their way of thinking. There's a scourge going on right now. People will say that it's progressive, but there's nothing progressive about abnormals with tangled genders or mixed race unions or young girls doing the dance of sirens.
That's not right. That's why your grandfather built this sanctuary for us, home, to worship in silence. See, Harpocrates is my patron god, the god of silence. And you'll find your god, you just need to open yourself up in a veil.
Who's my patron god?
I'm not sure. As I say, you'll find your god. You'll know when you know.
Who did Magda choose?
Magda was confused. She let the otherness in.
Was it Hades?
Gods, no. No. Magda had a good heart and soul. Her patron god was Aphrodite, the god of sexuality. But you're nothing like her.
You're full of nature. You like to get your hands dirty, be part of the world. That's why I think perhaps Artemis might interest you.
Race you back to the house?
You'll try.
She didn't do anything to you.
Hear me. Hear me. Hear me!
Thank you.
I am in control.
Yeah!
Take that, you dumb biscuit. Butch up, Gumblegort. We're going monster hunting.
Monster hunting?
Does Max ever talk about me?
He asked me how old you were.
What'd you say?
12.
You Iliad, Percy. I'm 13.
Why do you care about Max so much anyway? He's a boy. Pa says boys and girls don't play.
Did you hear that? Did you hear that? Come on, let's explore. Come on. Useless nincompoop. Thank you.
to the Gorgon. She froze me. I was in the woods, and she froze me like Medusa.
I thought she could only freeze me in my sleep, but it happened when I was awake. She looked like Medusa. Okay, so she has like this, layer. Her cave in the woods or something.
I don't want to call any more disruption onto your person than has already occurred. Let's settle this stir. By finding peace, the meaning of it will reveal itself in time. Here. Take one of these remedies. Wash it down with this tea. I take one of those when I feel an edge coming on.
But do you believe me?
Yes. I believe you saw something, Sprout. When I saw you convulsing out there like a Southern Baptist preacher in Sunday morning service, I was concerned. But a Gorgon can't do that. That was called upon by the gods for some reason. And to pacify them, I think it best we give Harpocrates an hour of quiet, silent meditation. That serenity, along with the medication and some bright thoughts will soothe you. Yeah?
Can I sleep here tonight?
I think that's a fine idea. Change the view of you. Yes. Sprout, don't go back into those woods.
Yes, Papa.
Artemis will protect you.
Freak out, okay?
What in Zeus's name is that?
It's nothing to be scared of. It's fine.
Thank you. Sprout?
Do you believe me?
You want to be an Amazonian, don't you? Come on, then.
It's good.
So you believe me, Papa?
Sprout. Go on. Go on.
Crawl space.
I saw something in my dream last night.
A gorgon.
No, it was a succubus named to tempt. They lure your thoughts into your dreams. I suspect they're haunting you as well. We must be vigilant. Sprout, it hasn't always been easy to believe and have the faith that I do. They've chastised me, called me names behind my back, snickered, called me loony, screwy Roy. I have to tell you, I'm struggling with my faith, Sprout. Ever since Magdala, I'm struggling being a good example for you and Perseus. Struggling being a father. It's as if nobody hears our quiet. We devote ourselves in silence to our Hippocrates. Nobody listens. The gods almost are working against us. And then my girl says she sees a gorgon. And at first I think it's one of your imaginary friends. And then I realize it's real, isn't it, Sprout? It's real, isn't it?
It's real, Papa. It's real.
It's real.
It's real.
It's real because that's what the gods have sent us. The gods have sent you in my image. You're special like me, only us. Only we can see the Gorgons, and we have to be vigilant. We have to protect Perseus. I believe you, Sprout. Sprout. All right.
Okay.
I'm gonna stand watching the porch tonight. Get some rest. By God, if you say there's a gorgon, there's a damn gorgon. I'm not gonna let him hurt you. All right. Hey.
Beautiful baby. We need you.
I get off for today. I'll call you.
Oh, you won't.
That's right. No phones. Listen, I know you're into the hermit life and everything, but do me a favor. Will you just get a landline for safety for me?
Well, first of all, this is the safest place there is. This is sanctuary, but for you, I'll consider it if you'll consider coming over for dinner tonight.
Got a couple pieces of fresh meat.
Mm. I'll bring the wine.
Dionysus would approve.
Hey, gorgeous. You let your hair out. It's pretty.
Take a hike, Ranger Woodhouse.
All right, Mr. Grady. Get a phone.
I don't want you meddling with the boys. Max is here for Percy's company. I think you should give Harpocrates an hour of silence. Been awful noisy this morning. Thank you.
Don't be an ass cracker about it.
Yeah.
Don't be an ass cracker, Percy.
You get used to his.
Ass crackery?
I like that word. So, I'm Sprout.
That's a funny name.
Well, it's not my real name. It's...
Look, your dad says I'm not supposed to talk to you, so.
Do you do everything grown-ups tell you to do? I thought you were 13.
I am.
Then why are you still playing baby toys?
It's not a baby toy, it's a drone.
Same thing. So, if you're done with your little game, you can come help me hunt for a monster.
Hey. I like your weapon.
Oh. Thanks, I made it. I like your hair.
My hair?
Yeah, it's wavy. Can I touch it?
Okay. Monsters aren't real, you know.
Yeah, they are. I'll show you. Ever been to a crawl space?
No.
Are you scared?
No, of course not. Hey, what's up with your dad?
He doesn't like it when girls and boys play.
He's kind of a hypocrite then.
What's that word?
Me do something is bad, and it goes and does it. Like flirting with my mom and asking her on dates and junk.
No. He wouldn't do that to my mama.
Your mama's dead, just like my dad. Our parents are widows, and widows need to heal with time and distractions.
No.
He says the crap my mom says. I don't like it either, but Your dad's weird. He talks to statues.
Shut up!
It's okay. I got those. It's okay. Come here. Feel the nice water.
Wine looks good on you. You know what?
Sorry. Oh,
sure, take it off. Take it off.
My
need
favorite.
Some, need some help with that? Hey, where's Max?
Percy's the benefactor of Max's company today. And last I saw, they were outside with that contraption of his, the whirly bird, and they're having quite a day.
He doesn't like you. He's not allowed to.
Well, that would be a shame because I like him a lot.
Why?
Because he's not ordinary, which is a good thing. He makes me feel like there's something to look forward to. Have you ever felt that way about a boy? Well, one day you will, and you're gonna feel it, like right down here, like in the pit.
Not allowed.
Yes, you are. And when you do, I want you to listen to it, and I want you to swallow it whole, okay? How was your hang with Max today?
He didn't make me feel like I had something to look forward to.
not much up here.
Careful.
We should. Careful. We grow herbs up here.
So what kind of herbs you grow up here?
I haven't really cleared this area. Hey, we should get back. Children.
No. Come on. I know you want this.
Stella. We should be getting back.
Come on. I've seen your statues. I know your deity. It's all an act. But I see you. I see you.
Not an act.
Take my children. You must atone. You must atone. You'll be judged in Tartarus.
Now, where you'll be judged. Sorry that you had to witness your father have a state of momentary weakness. Sometimes that feeling just overcomes you. You know that feeling, that tingling. I know you felt it, right? I mean, I know you do. And it tingles.
and you don't want it to go away. Oh no, what do they say? The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak.
We don't have to worry about that anymore. Sprout, I took care of Mrs. Woodhouse and that insolent, surly, unruly little son of hers, Max. Yeah.
No.
I've put them in Tartarus, where they will be judged accordingly. No. Now you know, my dear Hippocrates, it's the god of silence. But had you done your studying, how did you do your studying? If you had read, you would know that many gods align themselves with multiple domains, and one of which of Hippocrates is that of secrets. And I have a secret. I have a secret, little Sprout. I have a secret. I have a secret.
Oh, me.
I have a secret. This vision is fulfilled. I can tell you.
No.
Quite the noise.
No! Magda, no!
Magda, yes! Magda!
Oh! How she danced! And how she screamed! Oh, Zeus! How she screamed!
No! You didn't have to do that!
What was I to do? She let the otherness in! With those saucer eyes, tempting me! Tempting me until I was white knuckling, but now I'm free. Am I getting through to you? Because, Sprout, I would never hurt you. You're made in my image. Remember? I had you. And you had me. All you have to do, Sprout, is find your patron god. Yeah. And everything will be.
Gods!
I don't want you going down there, you understand? Your sister is suffering the consequences of disobedience. You don't want to experience that, do you, Perseus? No. Always the good, obedient boy. Come. Let's go ahead.
We're gonna keep our eye on the ball right there, right? Head down. We're gonna rotate. And drive. Whoa! Mighty fine, son. You try it. Go on.
Ah. Why don't you go get me a cup of coffee, Percy?
Lots of creamy sugar.
I'm sorry.
play golf?
Do you trust me? We're leaving. It's okay. You're not an Azkrak. You're a king.
We have to go. Where? Tartarus.
Perseus.
Back.
What? Please, I'm in danger. Please help me. I need your help. Please.
Quite an experience to be afraid, isn't it?
And drive!
Do you know how much I miss your mother? We used to come here and dance with others like us. Ate and drank and reveled in each other. We had different gods then. The Luptus. I can almost hear drums. But we were young and wild and free. And then you children came. And I tried to be best father that I could. But your sister, she didn't make it easy. She was noisy.
Finally, I chose one god, and you're not letting me have her.
That's not the god to choose, Magda. You know better than that.
But Aphrodite
Look.
Was beautiful, like Mama.
Your mother wasn't beautiful. Your mother was selfish. Your mother was lustful.
She was nothing more than a filthy gorgon with a long pointed beaked nose. And that's what you're gonna turn out to be.
No gods. Only monsters.
What's your name?
Alma. My name is Alma.
Alma.
Slim Watts. Pleasure.
There's a ranger station a few miles out. We could just drop them there.
Or we could take them with us. They're cute.
Get in. We'll take care of you.
You kittens like music festivals?
I mean, where are we gonna take them? They look like they've been through hell.
one's an original. You might have heard on the local walkie airwaves. It's called Good Riddance, Daddy. I said, good riddance, Daddy, no, you're just a fool. Can't trust your ways, so I broke the rules. Lived your lies, you tried to cheat and break my soul. But my heart is cold, tells me where to go. I said, good riddance, Daddy, is all we wrote. I said, good riddance, Daddy, it's all we spoke. I said,